This is Session 11, Share the Project. Sharing exports a file, compresses it, and sends it to a destination. Destinations are locations such as YouTube, Vimeo, CNN, and others. Sharing could be as simple as exporting a master file, which is my personal favorite, or as complex as exporting the project, compressing it for YouTube, then uploading it directly to your YouTube account. Export means to convert a project into a single media file, which is saved to your hard disk. Share means to export, then do something with the file, such as compression and uploading to a particular website. And destination is the location you tell Final Cut to send a shared project. Destinations first appeared in the 10.06 release. Apple and I have a divergence of opinion on sharing. Apple wants to make the process as simple as possible by combining exporting with compression and file delivery. I prefer to do these as separate steps. First, I create a master file so I can review it for quality. Then I compress and deliver it using software other than Final Cut. My three-step process takes a bit longer, but gives me more control along with the ability to spot and fix problems faster. However, sharing is much faster than my three-step process. This movie shows how to create a master file. So let me show you how to access the Share menu, review the destination options, share or export a master file, and review the export options. Well, let's pretend that our project is complete and we're ready to share it with the world. Well, except, how do we do it? Well, this is a project. Projects are created under the File menu. If we go down to File, look, there's Share. And these are some of the destinations that Final Cut makes available to us. There's a whole bunch more that we'll talk about in Chapter 13. We could burn this to a DVD or create it for Apple devices or Facebook, YouTube. These are all wonderful choices. I'm sure their mothers like them, but I never use any of these. My choice is always a master file. Notice the keyboard shortcut is Command E. So the way that we would share a file, just doing this again, is make sure that it's open inside the timeline and either type Command E or go to File, Share, Master File. This opens up the first of the master file windows. If I roll over here, I'm able to quickly skim my project to make sure, yep, that's the project I want to see. It says that it's a standard def project at 2997 frames a second. Stereo audio runs about 48 seconds. It's a QuickTime movie. It's going to take about 300 megabytes to store given the current settings. Tags we'll talk about as we get farther into this training. So most of the time, I leave all these settings alone. I click on the settings window. Do I want to export video only, or audio and video? 99.976% of the time, because I measured it, I'm going to want video and audio. When it comes to video codec, my general recommendation is always export the format that you edited. And for me, I've standardized on ProRes 422, especially for videos for the web. There are good reasons to use other codecs, but for me, I will always export my master file at the highest quality, which is equal to the format that I edited. You can change the codec from this pop-up. QuickTime Movie Linear PCM means uncompressed audio. That's absolutely the best choice. If you want to include chapter markers, and we haven't created any, you would check this. I'm going to uncheck it because there's no markers or chapter markers in this project. What do I want to have happen after I'm done outputting? Do I want to open it in QuickTime Player, do nothing, send it to compressor, move it to the iTunes library? Well, it's my curmudgeonliness. I'm going to do nothing. What I really should do is check opening this with QuickTime Player, but most of the time when it's exporting, I'm in another part of the office doing other work, so I just have it do nothing and I'll open it when I come back. We're going to talk about roles in the chapter on audio. For right now, leaving roles to QuickTime Movie is a perfectly okay thing to do. This is how you determine the settings of your export. Now we have to actually export. Click Next. This opens up a window. If you click this button, you just get a simple window. If you click this button, you get a more complex window. I'm going to keep it simple. the top line, I give the file a name. I like Interplanetary Internet Project, so I'll leave that alone. But I don't want it stored in a libraries folder, because it isn't a library. So where do I want to store it? I could store it anywhere. Because it's going to have the life of a fruit fly, it's going to last only until this demo is complete, I want to delete it because I don't need to save it, so I'm going to store it to the desktop. Most of the time, I store my master files in a folder called Master Files that's always on my second drive. But for right now, I'll opt for simplicity. Again, to get full navigation control, click this little twirl down right here and click Save. The cool thing is exporting happens in the background. I can start editing a new project. There's our background timer. If I click it, it says, look at how fast this is being shared. I mean, it's done. But more importantly, I don't have to wait for exporting to occur. As fast as I open a project, Command E, hit the return key, save it, move on. I can be editing separate projects while old ones are exporting. I've taken advantage of this every week in my webinars, where I have to create 10 different versions of my weekly training. I'll just create them and export them, one right after the other. And then while the computer is busy calculating, I'm having lunch. Exporting, sharing is simple. It starts with file share. Sharing is the final step necessary to deliver your project to clients or the web. Making the proper choices here makes your project look great. Making the wrong choices here leads to tearing of hair and gnashing of teeth. Chapter 13 goes into detail on all the sharing options. This has been an excerpt of our most recent Final Cut Pro 10 training covering workflow and editing. For the complete version of this online training, please visit our store at larryjordan.biz/store. And thanks.